The second special joint session of House of People's Representative and House of Federation unanimously elected United Nations representative to the African Union, Salwa Xud, as Ethiopia's first female president today. Currently, she is in fact the only female president in the continent. News of her nomination to replace President Mulatu Teshome, who resigned later in the Ethiopian parliament, emerged yesterday from sources close to the government. Given her competence and qualifications, many Ethiopians seem to be of the view that she is overqualified to the position, as it is mostly ceremonial, for the prime ministerial system of government in the country gives almost all the power to the prime minister. There has been a rumor about reforming the power of the president, which will require constitutional rearrangement, but it is not certain if it is happening anytime soon. Salwa Xud was a career diplomat and has served as Ethiopia's ambassador to Tunisia, Morocco, Senegal, Mali, Cape Verde, Guinea-Bissau, Gambia, Guinea and Djibouti. In Europe, she served as Ethiopia's ambassador to France. "I feel a great honor that I am elected to serve my country and its people," she said in her first speech in the parliament. The role, status and contribution of women in Ethiopian society and peace dominated her speech. She likened women to family, family to a country and women to a country, apparently as part of her effort to emphasize the important role of women in Ethiopian society. "Women are pillars of a family. When women hurt, family hurt. More than everything else, the future generation will hurt," she added, noting the circumstances under which women are striving in all walks of life in the country. She advised Ethiopian women to maintain perseverance. "Building a generation that will not accept violence against women is one of the key components of her speech." The situation in the country seemed to be of a great concern to Ethiopia's new president. But she hopes to see Ethiopia free from discrimination on the basis of gender, ethnic and religion. Although Ethiopia made news headlines the world over in the past 7 months in connection with transition to democracy, all is not well in the country, primarily because of radical ethno-nationalism, mostly in Oromo region of Ethiopia, where there seem to be a dual government structure has complicated the business of fighting anarchy. It is no wonder that the new president is also emphasizing peace in her speech. "There is no option or shortcut to peace to build a big country," she said, calling Ethiopians to work together to for peace. Mulatu Teshome raised the dangers that ethnic politics is posing to the country in his farewell speech in the parliament, too. "Ethiopians need to stop looking at political and economic phenomena in the country through ethnic lens. We need to remember that the reason we want to focus on our national unity, while recognizing diversity, is because it is a guarantee for our prosperity and revival," he told parliamentarians.